I'll use this one. Okay, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to speak with you this morning. What I want to do is give you an overview from a national perspective on body-worn cameras, give some information about them, about what's out there, about what the research is telling us, and also about what makes good policy for body-worn cameras. First, let me briefly mention my background. I'm a criminologist. I have a PhD in criminal justice and criminology. So your comments about crime and all of that were very interesting this morning. I taught at the University of Maryland. I was with the Department of Justice for a number of years, and I'm a researcher by trade. My company is Justice and Security Strategies. We work with a number of law enforcement agencies across the country. And as part of our work, we're involved with a training and TA program put on by the Bureau of Justice Assistance. So the slide you see here is really the work that we do with the Department of Justice and the Bureau of Justice Assistance in providing technical assistance to jurisdictions that have already implemented or are implementing body-worn cameras. We have a national team of people across the country that assist agencies with issues, with policies, you name it. If it's related to body-worn cameras, we have experts who can speak to them and can speak about them and help out with them. So we're funded through the Justice Department to specifically do that. And so I do thank you for...
Just a point of clarification that the Bureau of Justice Assistance is part of the U.S. Justice Department.
Yes.
Justice, right?
Yes, it's part of the Office of Justice Programs. BJA has given out over $50 million in grants over the last 3 years for body-worn cameras. The Sheriff's Department is one of those recipients. And so they are eligible, as you all are, for technical assistance. I think we've opened it up, frankly, to every agency, every jurisdiction that would like assistance as well. So we can do a number of things. We can assist with policy reviews. On our website, there's all kinds of webinars and podcasts. We can do these kinds of things, provide you with an overview. I can also provide you with more in-depth information about body-worn cameras if you'd like. So whatever you need, we're happy to provide that to you. And so this is part of the effort by the federal government that occurred over the last 3.5 years. So when body-worn cameras became very, very important and relevant to the public and police, the administration in 2014 provided these funds for those purposes. And over the next couple of years, there'll be additional funding as well. And so I'm hoping that we can help you with all of this. The federal government has provided, as you see there, $50 million over the last 3 years, which has funded about 50,000 cameras for police departments and sheriff's agencies across the country. What I want to do is talk briefly about both the possible benefits of body-worn cameras and the possible costs of them as well. Both are extremely important. On this slide, there's a whole list of possible benefits, including things like increased transparency by law enforcement agencies. The hope is also that it will enhance legitimacy by police departments, and that public satisfaction will increase. There's a view that body-worn cameras may improve police behavior, as well as citizen behavior. That being on tape, the notion is that both citizen and police will behave differently. And because they're being filmed, they'll change the way in which they act. Hopefully in a more civilized way, if that's appropriate. But it may also show this is the kind of enforcement that's needed. It may also show the way in which citizens talk and express their views to the police on the street as well. The idea here also is to reduce citizen complaints and perhaps police use of force. That again, by changing police behavior, it's hoped that cameras will directly affect those two types of behaviors, as well as complaints by citizens. One of the things that the research is showing, and I'll show that in a minute, is that citizen complaints are going down. Use of force is going down, but there are also some mixed results with it. The view here, too, is that complaints will be expedited more quickly. That with evidence on hand, departments and officers will be more easily able to explain the complaints against them, as well as lawsuits. Importantly, I think, and it's not been studied real carefully yet, but the footage could improve evidence for arrests and prosecution. And again, some studies that I'll talk about very quickly will show some of that. Lastly, there are opportunities for using footage for improving police training. Okay, what are the costs? What are the consequences of body-worn cameras? One clearly is that citizens and officers' privacy are open for discussion, open for viewing if in fact the footage is released. And the questions about privacy really are dependent upon the jurisdiction, but privacy is an issue. And whether it's of the police officer or the citizens who are on tape depends on the jurisdiction of the state and how you feel about what should be released or what not, what should be redacted, what should not. Officer productivity and morale. In the beginning, we were seeing that officers were not happy with cameras, and so it affected their ability to do work and their wanting to do work. But again, as you'll see in one of the slides I have, those problems have changed a bit, again, depending on the department. There are HIPAA concerns in the sense that body-worn cameras can be worn in hospitals if necessary. In terms of medical conditions and things like that, those are HIPAA concerns for hospitals and for doctors.